So one fine day while you play Go, you play your favorite tree tree invasion, and your opponent play this move. For all joseki which gets solid territory, the last thing you ever want is for your opponent to enclose your stone out perfectly and get a perfect piece of wall on the outside. So let's look at one of the mainline joseki whereby white plays a double hane. So the best move over here for black is to cut over here. So you trade the two stone at the corner of the board for the freedom of your stone, so that black can develop later on in the game towards the right side of the board. Alright. So what does white wants when he play this move? One obvious reason is that he wants you to play over here, and then he atari you have to capture, and then he enclose your stone at the corner of the board. Alright. If you want to break this joseki, then you have to play this move, extend over here. Because if you play this move, white has only, technically, he only has one move he can play, which is c2. If he play any other things, let's say if he play moves like this, then you can just atari his stone, and this should be good for the black stone. So if he play this move, you extend, and up till this point, you should know that white should never block your stone right now. Okay, if he block your stone, then this is going to be a ladder capture, because once you atari this is a sente, this is a sente. So once you get this ladder capture, your win rate should be more than 70%. Alright, this should win blacks the game. So when black b4, the best move for white is to extend over here. So this will turn into a trade whereby black will capture these two stone and white captures the bottom. And this is sente for the black stone, and white just capture the bottom of the board. This is a solid piece of territory. And it's slightly better for the black stone. If you run this through an engine, then the engine will tell you that black will have an increment of 4% in his win rate. Speaking of weird joseki, there is actually this variation where black harness over here. So what he wants to do is that he wants to swap side. He wants to swap towards the left side of the board. Okay. So don't play this joseki, because AI thinks that this is a horrible joseki. Black win rate at the end of the day will be lower than 20%. Okay, so when black play over here, the correct way for white to respond is this block. Don't capture the stone on the second line, because if you capture this, then this will actually be good for the black stone, because he has access towards the outside of the board. And this territory is quite significant for the black stone. Okay, so what white should do is just block over here calmly. And if black connects, then this is slightly better for the white stone. If black cut this stone, then white should just connect over here. Okay, don't capture the stone on the second line. Once again, if you capture the stone on the second line, then this double atari will give black access towards the center of the board. So just connect calmly. And if black swaps side, then this is the variation. AI preferred this move over b2 is because it removes the RG at the f3 area. So once you reach this point, white win rate will be more than 80%, and you can say thank you to your opponent.